Welcome everybody to another edition of Everyday Health Hacker. I'm Mike Herzing along with Dr. Lisa Liao, who is Chief Medical Officer at Meridian Health Institute in Sugar Land, Texas. How you doing?
Doing well. Excited about today's topic.
No kidding. This is the third part of a three-part series, at least three-part. I don't know.
I think it's going to be six.
It's going to be six or seven or whatever, all about pain management, relationships, and things like that, because we're giving you information that you can use to make informed health decisions. That's our whole goal of this whole series, and it's been awesome.
Awesome. Thank you. I'm looking forward to it because one of the caveats of pain management, you know, is that, you know, relationship. You know, a lot of people that are going through pain, over 120 million Americans suffer from some sort of chronic pain. And that's a lot of people. And, you know, then you also have on top of that, that doctors are very concerned about writing medications. And then you have the side effects of medications. And somewhere with that, many of them have a relationship, whether it is a spouse, a girlfriend, boyfriend, or maybe their children. All of those relationships are very important. And when you don't feel like, you know, even as a grandparent, as a mom, as a daughter, as a wife, you know, you don't want to keep saying, well, I can't do that. I don't feel good. So that's what we want to talk about today is that as we introduce relationship, how do we get from the clinical term of anhedonia, I don't feel like doing that, to being excited about being around the people that you love?
Well, it's tough. It really is. I mean, okay, you don't feel good and you've got pain, whether it's chronic pain or just pain that seems like it's never going to go away, that which is chronic pain. The doctor gives you medicine, which they don't necessarily want to, but you told them that your pain is at a 14 out of 1 to 10, and okay, they're going to give you some medicine. And then you start taking this pain medicine, and it just makes you feel like the person that you're not. You're
right.
Like, I hate taking this pain medicine.
Because a lot of people get agitated, or they are sleepy all the time.
Right. And then you're like, I hate taking this pain medicine. It just makes me a person that I'm not. Mm-hmm. And then you're like, okay, but I don't take the pain medicine, but then I feel bad.
Right.
And then it's like, okay, but then the other side, you get other people that are saying like, if I take this pain medicine, I'll get addicted to it, like opioids or this or that.
Right.
Whether it's right or wrong, they have this idea about that. And you're one of those, I hate to take pain medicine. You do
right.
hate to take
I don't
pain
like
medicine.
To take medication, period. And period, I'm a doctor.
Right. And you're a doctor, right?
Yeah.
And there are people out there that just, if it's a pain medicine, they're taking it.
Correct.
And I'm like, all right, I don't want to be like them, so I'm not going to take it. Mm-hmm. And that's not necessarily the way to approach things.
Right.
You've got to take it. You tell me.
So
you've
got to
take this. Might take it, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm like, you'll be all right. It's not going to addict you. It's just aspirin. You know?
Right.
And I'm like, all right, all right. And I'll take it.
Yeah.
And my wife's the same way. Take this thing. I was like, all right.
Yeah. But see, what you just said, like, all right, you know, that's part of the relationship because you're complaining that you're in pain, but yet you're not doing something about the pain. And we talked about in the previous episodes is that if you're over a four, it's 4.5, what have you chosen to do to feel better? And you can take an Advil, a Tylenol, an ibuprofen, a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory, Celebrex, meloxicam. That's just a few things that are not narcotics that can help with pain. There's plenty of things that are over-the-counter, Voltaren. It's a gel that you can put on areas that hurt. But when we are complaining, it's really hard to have intimacy when it's like, take this medication. No, I don't want to. I don't feel good. That kind of stops the conversation of the togetherness.
Yeah.
And then it's over and over. So what happens to that partner is that they even stop even trying to encounter intimacy. And that's not a good place because then you get further and further apart. And we all know that men are physical. Men need to be physical in order to feel that relationship. Women, you know, we can be doing the dishes and just they're in the house and we just feel connected and we're all there. Men and women have a different feeling of connection and you have to talk about it in order to have that oneness so that you can get through it together and make a plan together to increase the intimacy.
Well, sure. I mean, like
despite a pain.
Like they've always said, women need a reason, men just need a place.
There you go. Very well said. Very well said.
I think Billy Crystal said that in one of the movies, but it's just the way it is. And if you don't feel good, you haven't slept real well, you just
and you're complaining.
And you're maybe if you're not complaining, but to yourself, you're complaining and you get home and you just haven't had a good day and you just, okay, it's hard to be
excited about having intimacy about that, especially like if there's a birthday, an anniversary, or Valentine's Day, all of these things.
Let's go to dinner. I'm like, oh, I just want to go home. I just want to take a shower and go to bed.
And that's when it's kind of, you have to have a conversation.
Yeah.
You have to have a conversation.
Talk about this. Honey, I'm not really at my top peak form here. You know, we need to tone this down or this or that. And it's like, wait a minute, that's not really right. We shouldn't be doing that. And I need to be feeling better.
And that's also when you can say and have that other person to be able to say, what can I do for you right now to make you feel better? And it might
no one answered to ask that, but yeah, sure.
But we know what the male answer is going to be. We know what the male answer is going
to
be.
That's right. What's the other thing I can do to make you feel better?
Yes. Because yeah. It is something where I always share with patients. I'm like, you know how you put ice on an injury? Right. Well, we kind of have an acronym, and that ICE is all about creativity.
Right.
And it's doing different things so that you can be creative, whether it's in the living room, the bedroom. It's finding that to where you're comfortable and you're at peace and you're comfortable enough in the pain to be able to say, you know what, I don't want to miss out on the intimacy and the togetherness. And that's why we wrote Cupid's Challenge, was mm-hmm. to talk about different scenarios of different couples, whether they're boyfriend, girlfriend, or, you know, they were married couples, is, you know, not missing out. You know, it's the gentleman that's saying, you know what, I'm just going to watch the football game longer because she's going to be asleep by the time I get there.
Right.
And then that happens night after night, and now this big chasm of no communication occurs. And she's waking up in the morning, like, how'd you sleep, honey? Oh, my hip still hurts. Great. That's exactly what he wanted to hear. Instead of, you know what? I slept really well. Whether you did or you didn't, come on. You got to work with the role here. Mm-hmm. And that's why I want you to talk to your doctors about this, because there is medication and things that we can do to help you to get past that so you can get back to your life.
Or that, or make this is the day we're going to, this is our date night.
And sometimes you got to schedule it in. I share that with many couples.
This is the day I'm not going to complain. I'm not going to feel bad. Mm-hmm. And even if I do, I'm not going to say anything. And this is going to be the one day that.
Which is a great practice, because mm-hmm. it teaches you for that one day that you are not going to complain.
That's right.
And if you can learn how to do that for that many hours, you can learn to do that, because it is a learned behavior to be able to. There's a difference between saying my back hurts and my back is tired. So there's different languaging that you can have in order to communicate what your needs are, mm-hmm. because you know what? You both might want to take a hot bath, relax together, and then that leads into intimacy. But you have to talk about it.
Right.
And in talking about it can bring phenomenal intimacy going forward.
Ooh, I like that. Now, yeah. That's all in this book?
We do write that, you know, we have written that in Cupid's Challenge, because we don't want Cupid to be a challenge. We want it to be fun, engaging, and exciting.
Different ideas.
So we talk about, you know, a couple, like I'd mentioned, you know, he's like, I'm going to keep watching the game because she's going to be asleep before I even get there.
But she's not asleep.
But she's not asleep, because she's complaining about, he's going to come in here and I'm going to need to perform, and then I'm not going to feel good, and then what happens when we do this? Well, it's thinking about what can we do. And that's also on her part, too, mm-hmm. because it might be, you know, like, no, really, honey, you need to come to the bedroom now.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, come on, you know, we talked about this. So it's having that open communication. And yes, you're going to feel a little funny talking about it at the beginning. And then all of a sudden, it's going to become a normal part of, hey, the kids are asleep. We've got time. Let's make this happen.
Right. So, you know, it really is another level of intimacy. It's actually a better deal.
Absolutely. Because you're in love and you want to show uh-huh. that love with each other so that, you know, it is pleasure. And pleasure, you know what? It overcomes pain. So there's nothing wrong with that.
Not a bad idea.
So I encourage people can get this on Amazon or any of our link trees, which is on our Instagram, Everyday Health Hacker, Meridian Health Institute. And, you know, it's paperback. They can get it to you within a week. Sometimes it's even overnight, or you can stop by the office and we'll be glad to, for those of you that stop by the office, we'll be glad to share that with you, a signed copy.
Awesome. Sign it.
Ooh, yes. Look at that. Yes. We send little notes for you.
It's all
about encouragement.
You need to try that. Cupid's Challenge.
Cupid's Challenge. So embracing, restoring love, affection, intimacy, and respect through the challenges of chronic pain.
You had me at intimacy.
There we go. Yes. Well, we're going to be talking more about it as we go through this next series on this playlist, and we look forward to your comments, and we hope that you will subscribe to our channel.
Awesome.
Have a blessed week, and we'll talk to you soon.
Have a great week.